We're live.
Hello, Internet. How are you doing today?
My feet are wet.
Tim will be speaking for the entire Internet today.
I'm sorry to hear that, Internet. Have you tried turning yourself off and back on?
No, but I did put my feet in rice, and it seems to be helping.
Interesting.
Internet, let me get your take on the latest memes. How do you feel about the Epstein memes, and how do you feel about Alphabet Boys? And the Boogaloo.
I'm sorry, I thought we said the latest memes?
This is Brian's latest memes.
Yikes.
I only just found out that I could turn these servers into grouped into folders, and apparently that's been around forever, so I'm pretty behind on the times.
Yeah.
It's okay, Brian. You'll get there one day. I have faith in you.
Well, I don't.
Fair enough. Okay. Let me write down names quick. Haha, pencils would help. Where are... Am right?
Do you want my numbers again?
In a second, I have to grab stuff. Okay. Yes, I will take your numbers. Lon Dray. Oh, you just... Okay.
My Photoshop is broken.
Attaboy.
I don't remember what happened last time. I know that we delivered the wolf's bane to the wolfy boy, and then that's all I remember.
That was pretty much it. I think you had done the entire, like, all of the combat last time as well. And the, getting chased by the werewolf.
Yeah, but I was trying to remember, like, where we left it.
Where we left off the episode. I think you had just left his house.
Oh, okay.
And it was like 3 in the morning, and you guys hadn't slept in like a day and a half or something.
Don't we have another mission to do?
You do. Yes, you had picked up the little mission slip for Millicent to clear out rodents or what have you from a newly purchased home.
I was trying to think of a permission slips pun, and I'm not getting anywhere. Well, now what shall we do?
I'll be completely fucking honest. I don't remember what the fuck we did last time, and I don't know what we're working on.
We just discussed that, like, right now.
Well, I guess I'm Brian tonight. So why don't you re-explain?
Brian, you want this one or have you already begun?
We just left the dude's house after delivering the wolf's bane and now we have to go hunt up a bunch of mice in a basement.
All right. I remember that now.
Hooray!
What time is it right now?
It's like 3 a.m.
All right. Well, Lon Dray, I'm going to go and turn in for the evening. You, however, I don't care what you do. So, ta-ta for now, and I suppose I'll see you in the morning.
What are you going to turn into?
Hopefully dead, Lon Dray, so I never have to speak to you again. And Brad just fucking storms off towards the nearest inn.
Lon Dray is gonna go see if he can find any animals nearby out that are like outdoor animals.
God.
Okay.
Eric,
I mean, you're currently in the walls of a city, but...
Maybe somebody raises chickens or something.
In a city?
I don't know.
Okay. So, Brad, you have the option of going either to the guild hall, which has beds, or you can go to an inn.
What is the freer option?
The guild hall is free to adventurers.
Fuck yeah, that's where I'm going.
Okay.
I will, I'll look for any animals, not necessarily farm animals.
No, just outdoor animals.
Yeah.
Why don't you roll an investigation? Jesus, I don't know.
Brian is the only player, Brian is literally the only player that I have ever heard that at least once per every session... A DM questioningly says a skill check because they don't know how the fuck to deal with what bullshit Brian is bringing. Like, I was listening to Cam DM him, and at one point, I don't even know what the fuck Cam says, like, make an athletics check? And you're like, oh my god, Brian does it to literally everyone. Everyone.
That makes me feel a lot better.
I rolled a 12.
Okay. I mean, there are some birds around in the trees. There's not a whole lot of trees, but there's like one kind of, almost like a town, not town hall, city center is what I was thinking of. With like one big tree.
I'm a pretty big boy, so I better choose the big tree.
Okay. Are you, like, climbing it? Or... Mm-hmm. Okay. It's not even, like... You don't have to roll to even check, because it's pretty much, like, the big climbing tree that they keep in the town instead of having, like, a park or something so kids can go play there. So you're able to get all up in those branches.
Okay. I'll probably spend the night there, and I'll probably chirp at anybody that walks by underneath this tree.
Okay. there is...
Eric, he's not rubbing weird shit on his body. It's fine.
I'm fine. Yeah, you honestly don't see anyone walk underneath you.
Okay.
It's a pretty quiet night.
Are there any bugs up here that I see?
Yes.
I'm going to try to eat some of them for dinner.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, you're, like, picking at ants. And, like, And then you finally see, like, a big, fat, like, grub. And you go to grab it, and then an owl, like, swoops down and kind of caws at you.
I fight.
The angry owl noise.
I fight over it. I'm gonna try and get it with my flail.
Okay. Roll it at disadvantage.
Ah, that was a good one. 15 attack.
Watch Magni have like a fucking mascot owl that everybody loves.
You start to swing at this owl, and then like as you're about to hit it, it like hops back on the branch, and then it pecks up.
It pecks a what?
The grub that you were fighting for. Like, you swung at it, and it just went, like, hop, humph.
Bastard. Alright, well, if nothing else happens tonight, I'll probably just go to sleep.
Okie dokie. In that case, nothing else happens. Yeah, it's a pretty quiet night right now. Almost surprisingly quiet for how big Magni is, but yeah, you have no like familiarity with the city, I don't think. So maybe it's always quiet. Maybe there's a curfew or something, you know? Yeah. And morning comes and people are up and they're at like 5 a.m. So you've been up there for like 2 hours by the time people start like setting up carts and stuff to sell wares.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to just, I'm just going to yawn and kind of ruffle my feathers and then climb down.
Wait, do you have actual feathers?
Or no, you... but he's
okay. I just
pretending.
I'm like, wait, are you an Aarakocra? I thought you were a Goliath. What's going on? okay, yes. Brad, how late do you want to sleep in?
Probably pretty late. I think Brad is going to... He's going to get his 8 hours and more. So I'm thinking 10:30, 11 o'clock, he'll probably roll out of bed.
Sure. And Lon Dray, are you doing anything in that time, or are you staying up? You said you hopped down from the tree.
I'll just probably go eat something.
Okay. Yeah. The Guildhall does offer meals as well. It's very much like an inn. And
I'm going to go in and I'm going to say, I'll have what he's having, and point at one of the spaces between the chairs.
Okay. Shauna kind of looks at you, and there's clearly a recognition in her eyes as you're that huge weirdo. And she's just like, sure thing. Breakfast is porridge today. And she ladles you a bowl. Are you just staying? Hey, bud.
I'm still a guild member. Can I have a free drink?
Oh, yeah, what you want?
Anything is fine. What would go best with oatmeal? Porridge.
Coffee? Probably. I mean, some people like ales, but...
Can I have them together?
Gives you that look like, who the fuck is this guy? But she like takes a tankard and half fills it with coffee and then like looks at you and then fills the rest with ale and then kind of does that hesitant like motion to set it down, like, okay.
I'm gonna grin and then grip it, cup it with both hands and slide it towards me like they... and stare at it like they did at the pints in Lord of the Rings, and then I'm just going to eat and wait for Bradley to show up.
Okay. You're there for several hours when Brad groggily makes his way down the stairs.
Probably don't see him.
Brad's muted.
Sorry, I just saw the meme that you posted in the outhouse, and so I've been cackling for the last, like, I don't know, 10 minutes. Or however long I've been muted, that's how long I've been cackling.
I only just now.
Only because I have already started bullying Lon Dray. And no bullshit, like, then I see that meme, like, yup. Yup. So Brad will walk up to the bar and say, "Coffee, please."
Sure thing. You don't want ale in yours, do you?
No, that sounds awful.
It's quite.
What type of degenerate would do that?
It's quite delicious, sir. I recommend that you... Oh. Hello.
I hate everything about you, Laundry.
She sets a mug of coffee and a bowl of porridge in front of you.
I'm gonna slide my bowl and mug over and, like, scoot closer, closer, closer to him until I'm right beside him, and then I'm gonna lean over and say,
"Bradley,
is this one of those things where you're going to wait until I respond before you say your question?
What did you turn into last night?"
"I'm going back to bed, Laundry. Perhaps tomorrow we can try this again." I'm just not feeling it today. I think I'm just going to take a self-care day and... just really recharge my mental health.
Taking a me day.
"I turned into a bird." "Bradley, can..."
"Is there any possibility that you could turn into some sort of a sentient being with a brain?"
"Can I tell you, I didn't like it. Did you know that they have to fight over their food, and then when they finally get it, it turns out to just be bugs?"
"Laundry, have you ever wondered if maybe you had been smaller, perhaps you probably wouldn't have survived to such a ripe old age?"
"I have never thought about that."
"There's something to be said for a hearty constitution, and yours must be the heartiest, because... you have absolutely eaten poisonous things before, haven't you?"
He nods enthusiastically.
"Yes. Yes, you have, Laundry. Yes, you have."
"I am pretty big, aren't I?"
"Do you believe in karma, Laundry?"
"Karma, Laundry?
I believe I must have done something incredibly nefarious in a past life."
"Karma.
Do you know why I think that, Laundry?"
"Don't tell me."
"Because in this life, I am settled with you."
"You didn't really give me time to guess."
"Well, I didn't want you to strain your brain."
"I appreciate that. Do you want some porridge?"
"I do have my own, thank you, Laundry."
"Do you want some beer, coffee?"
"I don't. I've made it abundantly clear that I thought that was disgusting."
"I've tried to find a name that I could call this. It's like coffee and ale. Kale."
That's a great name.
I will.
You should go with that.
I'll call it Kale.
Laundry, I bet you could probably take these rats on by yourself, don't you?
I've never fought a rat before, but I fought an owl last night. I lost.
Well, here's the thing. Most owls do eat rats, and so realistically, you're fighting a lesser thing on the food chain, Laundry. So it should be easier.
I may be able to do it, yes.
Here's what I'm thinking, Laundry. I will accompany you to the house. I'll help you with the talking part. And then I'm going to go see if I can find a sauna or a spa.
For your self-care day.
Treat yourself, Laundry. Treat yourself.
And I will redeem myself from losing against the owl.
By killing all of the rats. Yes, Laundry, you get it.
Cut off their food supply and they'll die of starvation.
Yes, sir. And also on top of that, remember we're still doing the standard 70-30 split.
I get 30 and you get 70.
Well, of course, I would not dream of taking 30 from you.
How do you think I should spend my 30 gold pieces?
You're right. We are only going to give you 30 gold pieces.
Yes, you just said that.
Well, just try not to spend them all in one place, Laundry. And remember, if you eat too many sweets, you might get bellyache. But I don't give a damn if you do.
Laundry's going to be quite optimistic about this day. They're going to have a good day, so he's going to down the last of his kale and wait for Brian to finish.
Yeah, I'll finish up my coffee and porridge, and we can start making our way towards the house.
Okay. From the guild, the house is not terribly far. While the guild is kind of in the southern, just south of the castle, this house is listed as being kind of just northwest of the castle. And as you get further and further, around the town in this direction, you see that there are fewer of these apartments that are just stacked one on top of another, and more small domiciles. There's still no real, yards or anything. And the houses are built almost, square up next to each other. But there's a little bit of room in between them now. And by the time you get to Millicent's house, they are about the size of, a standard ranch house.
I'll go knock on the door.
When you get up, there's this big fancy knocker in the shape of a lion's head with a ring in its mouth. And when you knock, you hear, "Coming!" And this wizened old man opens the door, and he's wearing a tailcoat and fine slacks and a bright red cummerbund, and he goes, And he looks you two over and goes, is there something I can help you with?
My name is Bradley. This is Laundry. We are here from the Magni Adventuring Guild about the rats in the cellar.
Yes, Madame Bulstrode did mention. Come in, I'll go get her right quick. Please, sit down. And he ushers you into a bit of a sitting room.
Mm. Fred will sit down and just kind of watch Laundry to make sure that he doesn't do anything stupid.
I'm going to start looking around the living room and looking under furniture. And
as you look around this room, you notice it's immaculately well-kept. Not a speck of dust or a spot of grime. And no stains or anything on this kind of red velvet upholstery on all of the sit-upons.
After a while, I'm going to plop down on one of the couches or chair or something and say,
well, no sign of rats yet.
As you say that, this rather large woman with what looks like one of those, like, judge's wigs comes in and goes, oh, heavens no, they're not in my house.
All right. Well, where are they?
Well, you see, my neighbor, right to the north, recently fled town. Something to do with debts to the city. So I asked to purchase his house so I could merge the two, if you will. But when I went to have a look-see-loo over, I heard scrappling, scrambling noises from downstairs. Heavens, I would never set foot in the house if I had known there was something like that in there, but I figured I'll hire some of those, what do you poor folk call each other? Adventurers, that's it. And let them take care of it, and, give them a nice shiny coin for their hard work.
I was actually going to get 30 gold for this job, and he was going to get 70.
Laundry, please shut your mouth.
She said a coin. That's not going to be...
Laundry, shut your God's loving mouth, please. Motherfucker. My fucking headphones are dying. God damn it. I need to go get a charger real quick.
Hurry back.
This just happened on the latest Fillmore's Crossing episode.
What?
Some crazy old woman?
Dying, to talk to you? Dying headphones, but I cut that part out, so it's not appearing in the episode.
Oh.
Dying laundries?
You should go to bed. You guys can keep going. I can hear you and shit.
Oh, okay. Where is that? Oh, yes. So she goes, so, yes, if you would be so kind as to, go in there and, sort of clean out the problems, I'm sure that when he left, he did leave some sort of, valuables of some sort. I wouldn't mind if you sort of ransack the place and take what you
Ma'am,
want.
Ma'am, that is not how this works. You will have to pay us a certain amount as well, and we will also ransack the place.
Oh, yes, yes. I believe the agreed-upon price was, 100 gold? 150? What was it? Quincy? Quincy? What was that price that we had agreed upon?
Brad is going to use fucking hold on, what's the fucking cantrip? Cuz I heard Quincy talk, right?
Yeah, it was the old guy that greeted you earlier.
All right, hold on. Oh, I don't know if I have this. Because minor illusion lets you... Oh, it's an object, not a sound. No, I can. I can create a sound. Okay, so can I use minor illusion to make his voice say 300?
Yeah.
Okay, because that's what I'm going to do then.
Okay. So you start to hear, like, this shuffling from upstairs, where you are assuming Quincy is kind of getting up, and then you just hear, 300! Coming from, like, the hallway. She goes, hmm. Well, that's higher than I thought, but...
Oh, that seems all right. That'll be all right. We'll take 70 and 30. That's what we were expecting.
Shut your God's loving mouth, Laundry. You fucking imbecile. Go. Go start heading towards the house. I will take care of the rest of the negotiation.
I'm going to walk outside and try to figure out which house it was.
Okay.
And Brad will shout after him, you've been a very bad boy, Laundry. Think about what you've done. And then he'll look at the lady and say, Magni is trying a new program with the special needs where we bring them around adventuring. And I have to admit that it's not working out as well as we had planned, but community service is of the utmost importance to the Magni Adventuring Guild. So I will see you when the job is done to collect our 300 gold. Adieu, good lady.
Yes, sounds quite lovely. And don't worry about any bodies you leave. I'll have someone dispose of them at a later time.
Well, that is if my associate doesn't try to eat them first. Have a good day. And he'll just leave. He will not offer any explanation to that at all.
How did I do with deducing which house it was?
Roll nature?
Okay. So I need to turn off my headphones for like 10 minutes in order to charge enough to get another 2 hours out of them. But since Laundry is going to do this by himself anyway, I'm just going to mute myself for a little bit, and I'll type in the chat when I'm good.
Okay.
12.
Yeah, I'd say you can figure out which way north is. It's, right to your right as you exit her house.
Oh, I'm sorry, that was, well, it was an 11, but yeah, okay.
Yeah, still.
All right, then, I guess I'm just going to waltz right inside.
Okie dokie. So, walking in, you see a 15 by 40 foot hallway. Immediately to your right, there's a large archway which goes into a, sitting room, much like the one that you were just in. And through that archway, you can see some stairs going up. And then it seems that there's three other doors, one to your left immediately, and then two more further down the hallway, one on the left, one on the right.
He's going to say to himself, if I were an owl, where would I eat? Owls fly high and live in trees. Probably upstairs.
Okay. Are you making your way to the upstairs then?
Mm-hmm.
As you do so, roll me perception.
13.
Okay. You. Aren't able to hear anything other than the creaking of floorboards as you walk over it. Other than the sunlight that's coming through several of these windows, it's slightly dark in this house, since it's still quite early. And most of the windows have, like, drapes pulled over them.
No sign of rats anywhere?
Nope. No rats.
I think it's about time that I turned in to a rat.
I'm going to get down on all fours and start squeaking my way around the house and probably head back downstairs and go through one of those doors.
Okay. So just so you know, on the second floor, it kind of opened up into an L-shaped hallway. And there were three doors on the left side of the hallway and one door on the right.
Well, okay, I'll check them out while I'm up here.
Okay. The first door on your left seems to be a rather standard bedroom, as does the second. There's a bed and sort of a like a chest of drawers at the end of it. The third door on the left is a type of office where there's really just one desk, scrolls still strewn about, and a chair kind of pushed over on its side at the back of it. And the door to the right opens up to what seems to be like a master bedroom, where there is a large bed pushed against the far wall, and then, like, to the left of it, there's a much smaller door, and to the right side, there's, like, a closet kind of open-up drawer, or doorway.
I want to open the small door.
Okay. It opens up into a... it looks like an outhouse, except it's indoors. So an in-house, or a bathroom, as we call it.
Water closet, in that time.
Actually, this is set in the year 3000, Tim.
Nah. Got him.
Have you ever seen that episode of Futurama where they're going to all of the different time periods and they're singing that stupid fucking song?
Yeah.
Now in the year 30, 30, 40, 50... I don't know why that reminded me of that. Sorry. Anyway.
Probably because it's the distant future. Welcome to the world of tomorrow.
I want to dig through the dressers, drawers.
Okay. In the master bedroom?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. There is a lot of kind of out of fashion suits, as well as there is a very fine set of kind of silky gloves. They are blue with little swirls on them, except for patterns that are kind of stitched into it, where they're red with crisscrosses.
I'll try them on.
They're a little snug on you, but they feel very comfortable.
I'm going to... You said there was, this is a female or a male?
What?
This is a guy's house or a girl's house?
It was like a family's house.
Oh.
But the person who Millicent mentioned, fleeing was a man.
I'm just going to pull out more clothes in not really necessarily male or female, just random clothes, and start putting them on.
Okay. There's, yeah, there's a lot of, like, suit coats with, like, really long, froopy tails on them. They kind of look like what Quincy was wearing. And then there are a few petticoats as well.
I'll grab, definitely grab one of the petticoats.
Okay.
And then after I've squeezed into these as best I could, I'm going to say,
if I were a person that lived here, where would I get annoyed with rodents? I wouldn't want them approaching me while I was eating. I'm going to head down to the dining room.
Okay. Excuse me. My map go? There it is. Okay, so the downstairs. Okay, there we go. I have like three maps drawn and they're all getting upside down. So you open up the door right across from the archway and it's a second sitting room, oddly enough. This one seems more like a entertaining sitting room, though, with, like, there's a bar and, some couches. And then the next room to the, on the left side of the hallway, is the dining room with a long oak table.
Do I see, do I see any drinks at the bar?
You see an opened bottle on the bar. If you go behind it, you'll see a couple bottles of wine.
I'll take one of the wines, and then I'm going to go look through the kitchen to see if there's any food left.
Okay. The kitchen is the last door on the right, and there is a large chest at the kind of back right corner of it, and at the back left, there's like a vented fire pit. And then there's also a rather humble-looking door, kind of dead center.
Did I find any food?
Yes. In the chest, you actually find that there's a some sort of cold spell placed on it. So when you open it up, you see some cuts of meat that seem to have stayed.
Cooked or
they seem pretty raw.
Okay, I'm gonna take one out and I'm gonna sit down at the table. Are they frozen or just cold?
They are kind of in between.
Oh, okay.
Like they're not quite frozen, but they're pretty solid, you know?
Yeah, I'm gonna cast purify food and drink, and then I'm going to start munching on this thing and say out loud, like,
I would be irritated if a rat tried to bother me right while I'm eating.
Do I see any rats?
Roll a perception check.
11. No, 12.
You do not see any rats.
I'm going to finish half the steak, and then I'm going to, I'm just going to start scanning the ground as I walk through this house and look for any holes in the walls or anywhere they could be.
Okay. Welcome back.
You didn't have to type, "I'm good."
Fuck you, Brian.
Maybe he's really good, Brian.
I didn't want to interrupt you. Just trying to be polite. Now I don't want to be polite anymore.
Politeness was not on your agenda. You were going to be bullying Brian today.
How, you love it. It's great radio. How long has laundry been in there at this point, Eric?
Probably about an hour.
All right, so Is there like a spa or anything, like a sauna, manicurist, fucking barber salon, like anything like that nearby?
Being in the kind of richer part of town, there is a there's like a masseuse, and then like kind of a pedicurist in the same building. Yeah.
It's, can I go get a shave and a haircut first, though? Because I've been traveling for a while, and I assume I probably haven't been keeping up with my shaves, so...
Sure.
How much... We don't have to roleplay it. How much gold do you want me to knock off?
For the whole thing, maybe 2 gold.
Okay. Cool. Brad will... tip a fucking gold piece at each. The only reason I'm doing a gold piece is to make the fucking math easier for me.
Okay. They are all very thankful for you.
How long did that take?
Staff. Probably 2.5 hours.
All right, I'll let you go back to laundry, and then I'll go do some more shopping and bullshit.
Okay. So, Lon Dray, you are kind of searching around looking for hidey holes that these rats could be, and then you kind of get all the way around the first floor, and you don't find any, and then you remember that door in the kitchen, and you're like, maybe this is more food pantries or something.
When I do that, I'm going to grab the steak on the way and take it with me.
Okay. So when you open this door, you find that part of it is food pantry. However, the other part is that it is a staircase going downstairs.
Well, I've looked about everywhere else.
Guess I'll go down the stairs.
All right. Get my downstairs map out.
As I go, I'm going to be going, squeak, squeak, squeak.
When you get downstairs, you see that there is a couple torches lit, so there's like some light being cast, and the way that the basement is set up is that it's like 2 rooms that are separated by this wall, and then both of them kind of open up into the landing area where the stairs come down.
Is it like a left or right situation?
Pretty much, yeah.
I will choose... Can I see inside, or are the doors closed?
The doors are closed, but the wall, like, right in the middle of them is kind of, like, broken. So you can kind of see into either one.
Is it dark and dank down here?
It is dank for sure, but there's some light flickering through the broken section.
I'm going to peer through the rooms before I go inside.
Okay. Peering into the right room, you see kind of this, this large trash heap, kind of like dead in the center. And that's pretty much all you can see in this. It looks like there maybe was like a little stage built up at the far wall. But that just seems to have more trash on it. And then the left room, it looks like a much more fancy bar, almost like an actual bar would have, where there's a few stools set up in front of it, and then like a door behind it, kind of like a back room.
Hmm.
And when you are looking into the bar, you see some creatures on the chairs.
Okay. What do they look like?
From what you can tell, they look like very small people.
What the fuck?
Maybe a foot tall.
Okay. In that case, I'm gonna knock on the door.
So you immediately hear like this chittering and then kind of like silence. And then you see a small face kind of peer through the little crack in the wall.
How small are we talking, these people? How short are they?
They're like a foot tall.
Okay.
And what languages do you know?
Common and giant.
Okay, you can't understand any of this, then. It just sounds like... It sounds a lot like rodent squeaks to you. And then, like, the face kind of disappears really quick, and then you hear a lot more of this chittering.
Would I be able to... Can I cast Speak with Animals for rat language?
Sure.
I'll do that, and then I'll say squeak, 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 which is going to translate to, can you understand me?
Excuse me. So, when you cast it, you hear, some of it still just sounds like chittering, oddly enough, but then the rest of it sounds like big, really big, big. Anything, grab it, go. And then when you speak, they all kind of get quiet.
And when they get quiet, I'm going to hold the steak up and be like, do you guys eat steak?
Roll a perception check.
Eighteen.
Okay. Rough. So you are offering this. Did you open the door, or are you just kind of holding it in the crack?
Correct.
Okay. So your arm kind of takes up most of this space. And then you feel something thwack you really hard on the knee. And you look down and one of them is holding like a ladle. And you take 4 damage as he cracks you right across the kneecap. And then he lets out a few more chitters, one of which says, "Get him!"
Ow. In rat, I'm gonna say, I'm just here to look for rats. I'm not here to bother you all. Can you tell me if you've seen any rats? As I'm rubbing my knee.
The one that's at your kneecap is just saying, "Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on," and then you hear another one like burst through the door, and it goes, "A feast, a feast." And it's going to try and stab you with like a broken bottle.
I'm going to assume they're talking about the steak, and I'm going to drop it in front of him.
Have all you want. I'm quite finished. I already ate breakfast this morning.
They are ignoring the steak, and they are slowly surrounding you. By slowly, I mean, like, they're running, but they're, like, really small. And...
I'm gonna sit down crisscross applesauce.
Okay. One of them's gonna swing a frying pan at you, then.
Swing a what?
A frying pan.
Oh, jeez. Surprised he can lift it.
He was dragging it along, and then he just kind of, like, threw his whole body into it, and it kind of brought his body with it. That's gonna be 8 damage.
Jeez! Fucking hell!
Bongs you across the head. That's the second crit I've rolled on you tonight.
At this point, I'm gonna start thinking maybe they're not trying to be friends, and I'm gonna, I'm just going to try and do, like, a wide swing with my flail all the way around me.
Okay. yeah, roll your...
Just want...
They're all still...
Just an attack?
Roll... I'll say roll 2 attacks with this.
Holy shit. One is a 23, and the other one is a nat 20 plus 5.
Okay. what's the damage for that?
The first holy one. Forking shirt.
The first one is a 6 damage, and the next one is a 7 damage.
And the 7 damage was a crit, so it's double.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So, you kind of just lash out with your flail, and you catch the one with the ladle, like, across the chest, and he gets knocked back, and he's kind of, like, on all fours, gasping, and he lets out a lot more of the chittering that you can't understand. And then you kind of backhand the one that had the frying pan, and you just knock him, like, he just flies backwards and he slams into the wall head first. he's not moving anymore, but the rest of them are still shouting, "A feast, a feast, a feast!" There's, you see, 2 more of them running out from the trash heap in the right room, and, 1 more of them running from the bar.
I'm gonna, as I'm kind of trying to stand up, I'm gonna say, "You weren't interested in my steak at all."
when they hear that, they kind of, like, it doesn't process for them right away that you're still speaking their language, and then they go, "Meat is meat is meat is meat! More meat!" and then... you want to roll initiative right away?
Tenner.
Okay. Dead even, then. Right in the middle. So the 2 from the trash pile are gonna run forward. One of them is holding a shoe, and the other one has, like, a jagged piece of plate.
Jeez.
Okay. The one with the shoe is going to slam it down on your foot for 1 damage. and the one with the little plate kind of takes a slash at you, but it just kind of... The plate actually, like, breaks on your armor. And it's your turn.
Now that I've gotten up, I think I'd like to draw my halberd.
Okay.
Can I do another wide swing, or do I just need to pick a person and attack him?
They are kind of cramming in two to a square, so I'll say that one attack is able to hit two people. Except for the one that is kneeling over.
18 plus 5.
Let me tell you, that'll hit.
Is 6, 7, 8, 9 damage.
Okay. These two... are you just attacking the two that just attacked you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. They get knocked back a little bit, and one of them is bleeding pretty bad. And then he starts, like, lapping at his blood. And the other one looks like it got, like, dazed a little bit with that hit. More than it got cut. But, both of them are looking pretty bad. No, excuse me. The one from the bar and the one that, had gotten booped earlier, are both going to try to, attack you. Jesus Christ, these dice are fucking amazing. Thanks, Libris Arcana. So the one that just ran at you from the bar is going to try to bite you. And he gets you, like, right in the back of the knee where your armor has a little bit of a gap.
Jeez.
And, yeah, that'll do 3 damage. And then the one with the ladle is going to swing and hit you right in the exact same spot on the kneecap. And that'll do 4 damage.
What's the total on those damage?
7. How you feeling, buddy?
I don't think I'm gonna have enough HP left to take on the rats after this.
It is your turn.
Oh, hold on. Realized I'm running on Wi-Fi when I should be running on. So, if I were, could I tell if I were to go where I came from, the door that led to the pantry closet, could I bottleneck them?
Probably. I mean, they'll still probably be coming up like two at a time.
Hmm.
But it would be less than 4 of them surrounding you.
I think I'm just going to go through there and close the door.
Okay. You are currently downstairs, so you've got to kind of run up the stairs then.
And am I going to take a attack of opportunity or not? Nah?
Oh, yeah.
From how many?
I would say 2 of them.
Do the two look pretty rough?
Oh, they all look pretty rough, yeah. They've all gotten slapped around pretty hard.
I'll probably try to attack them first and then maybe make a move after.
Okay.
I'll do the halberd again.
Mm-hmm.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
That hits.
Sweet. Son of a bitch. 13 damage.
Yep, you get clean swings on them and cut through them.
Okay. So I think as this is happening, like, the camera pans back over to Brad, and, like, this lady is just, like, fucking filing at his feet, and he'll be like, oh, ow, 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 my bunion, my bunion, watch my bunion! And then I think it goes back to Laundry.
And Laundry's currently, like, swollen and bruised and bleeding.
Right.
The lady's like, sit still. I've been doing this for 60 years. I know what's good for you. And it comes back to the floor just getting kneecapped.
And all the while saying, so you guys haven't seen any rats or... Yeah, I'm gonna, after I slash these two, are they dead or still, would I take off?
Yeah, I'm gonna, they're dead.
I go through and close the door.
Okay. I would say you're just able to get to the top of the stairs and close the door. But you hear the two of them that are left standing going, help! Help!
Great, so maybe there's more of them.
What? Brian, would I do that to you?
What is heavy? Is there anything heavy in my vision that I could set in front of this door? Is it? And also, which way does it swing?
It's those doors that kind of, like, unfold and fold in.
Oh. Fold or slide?
They're like the, accordion style.
Oh. And then does it lock?
It does not.
What about, is there a shell, are there like big shelves in this pantry or anything? Are they all attached to the wall or anything?
Yeah, there's just like nailed to the wall, the shelves.
In that case, are we out of initiative?
Sure.
Then I'm just gonna bolt. Probably try to get out of the house.
Okay.
Maybe grab the wine bottle along the way.
While you are running, you hear this really fast scampering sound coming up the stairs.
Okay.
Just bolting out the door?
Yeah.
Okay. Then yes, you are able to get out the door and kind of throw it behind you and lean against it and that... And then you hear, like, the... Through the door, you hear that scampering and then, like, scratching at the door.
Somewhere I have... Oh, here it is. I have a reservoir of 18 HP that I can expend for somebody, so I'll expend it on me.
Okay. That lay on hands?
I don't know what it's called.
Yep, it's lay on hands.
You have to lay down on your own hands for that, then.
Dude, please go and find fucking Brad, because that would be so funny.
Do I have any idea where he might have gone? He just said spa day, so...
You could search around the district. It's not an overly large district, but it seems like the nicest part of town.
I'll do that.
Okay. Roll investigation. See how long it takes you.
13, 12, 11.
Rough. So I would say you are able to find Brad right as he's finishing his spa day.
Well, is it all completed, Laundry? Shall we go collect our fee?
I'm gonna walk in with my head down and my bottle of wine open, but slinked at my side and just I'm gonna shake my head.
Laundry, I'm going to tax you 20 of your gold coins, and we're going to go fix this problem. Are you ready, Laundry?
I'm just gonna nod while still looking down.
Now come along, Laundry. Look up, keep your chin up. We all knew that you weren't going to actually accomplish this. And I don't want to hear a single other word out of your mouth until we are done. Do you understand?
Just nod.
Here's my Laundry.
I'm also still wearing the petticoat and all the clothes.
Oh yeah, Brad is just not asking any questions. He doesn't care. I think at this point, Brad has realized that he is going to get rich off of Laundry, and I think he's starting to realize that he loves this relationship more than he's ever going to let on. And so, yeah, Brad's gonna go and kick in the door and walk on in. What do I see?
When you walk in the door, you see these bloody footprints.
Are they size 24?
There are some size Laundry footprints. But then, like, in the puddles of blood, there's also more smaller ones.
I'm going to pull out my rapier and follow the smaller ones.
Okay. So you can see that they go two ways. One of them is, like, tearing out of the kitchen and, like, scrambling around the door. And then there's some pacing by the door, and then it looks like they turn back towards the kitchen.
All right, I'm going to rush into the kitchen.
They continue to the back cabinet, where you see a cooler half pushed, like, started to have been pushed against the door.
Okay, so I want to, like, whip it open, look, see my target, and then stab the fuck out of it.
You whip open these doors, and the footprints continue down the stairs.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna go down the stairs and wave on Laundry.
I'm following behind every step of the way, but I'm doing it all paranoid and just, like, looking around us all.
Okay. So when you get to the stairs, there's still that dim light, and the one door to the leftern room is opened, and you see that it's like a bar slash, you know, lounge area.
Is there a rock or pebble or something on the ground?
Oh yeah, there's a whole bunch of, like, gravelly.
I'm gonna pick one up, cast light on it, and just kind of drop it to create more light.
You see the three bodies of very, very small people. They don't seem to be wearing clothing other than, like, really tattered rags.
Maybe literal rags.
Yes. One of them appears to have its head caved in on two different sides. Two of them look almost cut clean in half.
Fuck.
And they're kind of scattered around this large puddle of blood.
I think Brad will give Lon Dray sort of the Robert De Niro nod.
And when you cast this light, you hear this really high pitched chittering from the trash area, the right room.
Come on out and be murdered like a whatever you are.
They cannot understand you, but you do see two of them kind of running at you from the trash. Still chilling.
How far away are they from me?
They are about 15 feet.
Okay, I am going to leap forward about 5 feet and Thunder Wave, second level.
Okay.
I just need to check. I think it's a it's a Constitution, DC 12.
One of them does make it. The other one gets a 12, so it meets.
Motherfucker. Alright, well that's still half of 3d8 damage to both of them. So I'll roll that right now. Uh, 13, so cut in half is 6.
They both get this, like the boom goes off and they both like kind of start to cower a little bit and cover their ears, and there's some like blood coming out of their ears.
Can I like get a surprise attack off on one of them?
Roll a dex check.
Fuck yeah, I absolutely will.
That was a bad one.
Well, that's a 15 plus 4 if it's just straight modifier, plus 6 if it's a save.
Just a check.
So 19.
Okay. So, I will say yes, but as you do so, you see this kind of figure darting out at you from behind the bar and letting out this really loud screech, but you can attack one of them.
So is that other figure behind me then? Like, would there be three of them that I see?
You see three of them, but you don't get a good look at the one that's coming. You just kind of get the glance that it's, like, running towards you. And it's letting out this really loud, like, scree.
So, can I actually cast Hold Person on the screen one, or do I not have a good enough visual?
You don't have a good enough visual.
Okay, I will just use my attack then.
Okay.
But I am absolutely going to spend a use of Bardic Inspiration. Motherfuck yeah! That's a 22 to hit. And so that is 15 damage, and my armor class is now a 19.
Jeez. Yeah, you just stab right through this one. And, like, it had its ears covered, and it was kind of, like, keeled over a little bit, and you just skewer it like a kebab.
Can we roll initiative, then?
Yeah.
Nope. Am I still 10, or you want me to reroll?
Holy fuck, Eric. I just rolled a 19, so that makes my initiative 23.
So you're really going to hate me because I rolled a 20, which puts his at a 24?
Oh, I'm sorry. I also have a 24, because my initiative is 5 because of Jack of All Trades.
Oh, yeah.
And I have a 4 for my dexterity, so I think I go first.
It also has a 4 for dexterity.
Motherfucker!
You want to just... okay, so you had... Hold on, let me write these down. You had a 24, it had a 24. Lon Dray, what did you get?
13.
Oh, that one was actually dope. So you want to roll against each other to see who goes first for this?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, just straight d20?
Yeah, that's fine. That just gave me a crit fail.
I rolled a 20.
Nice. Well.
Okay.
It is what it is.
Yeah. So this is actually the figure that just came around and dashed towards you.
Okay.
And as it kind of screams into the light from your little rock, you see that it's another one of these creatures riding a ludicrously large rat. And it's the only one that seems to be brandishing an actual weapon. He pulls a dagger out and brandishes it like a short sword.
I do like your gumption, old boy!
So he stabs at you. Jesus Christ. That's like the 5th crit I've rolled today.
Well, wow.
So, 24.
Yeah, so tell me what the damage is, because I'm going to parry it.
Okay. It is 16.
Okay, yeah, I'm fucking parrying that.
Yeah, that's a good choice.
So that's a 7 plus 4 is...
11.
Oh, wait, no, my superiority is a d6. I'm sorry, not a d8. My bad.
Oh, okay.
Oh, shit, well, 5 is still pretty good. So that's 9 of the damage negated.
Okay.
So that makes it, what, 7?
Yeah.
Okay. That's way more manageable, dude.
Yeah. And as the dagger plunges into you, you see this like glow in the rat's eyes. He's gonna take a bite at you, but he is much weaker, so. Does a 13 hit you? No,
because he's I have a 19 right then. No.
Yeah. So it like tries to bite you, but you just kind of yikes, Brian. you kind of buck back from being stabbed by this tiny little man. And the rat's not able to get a clean bite, but it is your turn now.
All right, I'm gonna do another thunder wave this time at first level, and so that's a con save for all 3 of the creatures.
One of them's behind you. The big one's behind you.
Isn't it? Oh, it's a... Yeah, I'd have to move. Never mind. I'll just do the 2 then in front of me, obviously. And, DC 12.
One of them died, if that changes your action.
Well, I thought that he was on the rat, though. That's what I mean by 2 creatures.
Oh, those 2. Okay, yes. Sorry.
No worries. Yeah, that's just what I mean. Like, I'm going for the 2 enemies as opposed to 1.
Gotcha, right. So he saves, rat does not.
Alright, so the rat is going to go flying 15 feet out from under him. Which is fucking wonderful.
Yeah.
So that is... So 7 and 6 is 13 again.
Okay.
So 13 to the rat and 6 to the big dude.
And now that he is dismounted from this rat, as it, like, shoots through his legs like a center snapping a football, and he looks kind of confused, he's about the same size as the rest of them. He was just, mounted on this large boy. And, Lon Dray, this rat, like, shoots back and is, like, right next to you now.
He starts to say, "Ah, we finally found one," but then he remembers he wasn't supposed to utter a word. So he gets out, "Ah."
The last. Oh, I dropped my die. The small man that you had thunder waved earlier is going to punch at you with his little fists, Fred.
Good luck.
Yeah. I don't think his 15 does it.
Nope.
But you do get a little bit of blood on you as his hands are, like, smattered with it a little bit.
God damn it! This is unacceptable! Lon Dray, this is your fault! This was supposed to be a me day.
Lon Dray, it's your turn.
Can I throw my wine bottle as a free action?
Are you throwing it at something or just in general?
At something.
Sure.
Okay, I'm taking I'm gonna take the last swig and just try and swing it down at that rat before I pull out my halberd.
The rat is prone, so
coup de grace?
You do have advantage on it.
Oh.
Is it prone or just knocked back?
Maybe it's not prone. No, you're right. It just says that it's pushed.
Eleven attack.
Maybe the wine's getting to you, but you completely miss this. You just kind of throw the bottle down at your feet.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to try and halberd this guy.
Okey-dokey.
Oh, jeez. Okay, 19, 22,
24. Dang, just misses.
What?
I'm kidding, Brian.
eight, nine, 10, 11 damage.
Hit it good. And one of its legs gets clipped and it's just kind of hanging on by a little scrap of fur.
Gross.
So it is going to take a bite at you for attacking it so viciously. And it's going to miss severely. And then it's going to run back to the rat rider.
Hey, whoa. Yeah.
I was going to say, you get an attack of opportunity. Lon Dray.
Oh, I do. Okay. Dope.
Mm-hmm.
It's 14.
14 hits.
Finish him.
Sixer.
Lived with 1 HP.
God damn it. God damn it, Lon Dray. You had one job.
It's like leaking blood out of all of its limbs, and it just gets back to the even with the rat rider, who is going to take another stab at Bradley. You said your AC is still a 19?
19, sir.
Oofta. Yeah, he got a 17. So he doesn't quite hit.
So, the fact that I've prepared 3 thunder waves for today is kind of obscene, but I'm going to thunder wave again.
Okay. Oh, right.
Get out of my face, please. Constitution 12.
17.
Motherfucker. What about the rat?
Oh, the rat failed. And it has 1 HP. Okay. So it's basically just exploding straight into laundry and dying.
10 damage to the rat and 5 to the guy.
Yes. Yeah, the rat just shoots back and ragdolls into laundry's chest.
Got him.
Got him. The last small man is going to attack you with his fists again.
Fair enough.
What's your AC down to now?
It's 16 now.
16. Oh, God.
Just missed?
15.
Ah, got him.
So he's still, like, flailing at you, and he actually, like, chips one of your nails. That was just done.
This motherfucker.
As he's just swinging his fists like the Bart Simpson windmill.
Laundry, that is another gold piece taxed off of your surcharge.
It's your turn, Laundry.
I stick out my bottom lip. Is anyone... who's left?
There was the rat rider and then the other smallman.
Distance?
10 feet to the rat rider and 20 feet to the other one. And then Brad's right in the middle of them.
I'm gonna do the 10 footer with my halberd.
Ooh. 19
plus
5. Yes.
And I'm going to, out of frustration of losing all of this gold and disappointing my friend, I'm going to smite him with my last spell slot.
Fuck yeah.
Where is my smite? Oh, I did this last time. I didn't have it written down for some reason. Oh, there it is. D8. Okay. It's a 10. Plus 3. Plus...
13. Oh.
Fucking 1.
14, then?
Yep.
Yep. You do a nice... vertical slash and cleave him in two, and then, like, instead of blood and gore spewing out of him, there's just, like, this radiant light. And then, Brad, can you beat a 23 athletic check?
Probably.
Okay. Roll an athletics check, then.
Okay. I mean, it's going to be hard, don't get me wrong, but I can. I don't. That's a 19.
Okay. So as this small being is kind of falling apart in slow motion. The last creature scrambles through your legs to be on the other side of you and grabs the dagger. And he's going to stab at you. The 7 does not hit.
Sure doesn't.
But he's clinging to hope.
Funny thing about Brad is Brad stabs back. And so that's going to be 17 to hit.
Yeah.
That's going to be 7 plus 4, or wait, hold on, it might be more than that. 7 plus 6, my friend, so that's going to be 13.
Yeah, that's enough to do him in. Go for it. How does this last tiny creature...
Okay, so I think that it, like, stabs out at me with the dagger, and so Brad will just slap the dagger out of its hands, and then, like, slowly keep backing it up, like, more and more and more and more and more, until it, like, trips over one of its dead compatriots, and then he's just gonna stab it down through the face.
Oh, poor BB. You did it! Hooray!
Laundry! I didn't really even need you here. Like, I could have just done this myself.
I'm just going to pick up the steak off the floor and start eating it.
Gross. Well, I suppose all that's left is for you to clear the house. I'm going to go and cure my wounds. I'm also going to see if they left any liquor behind.
Can I talk yet?
Laundry, once you are confirming that the rest of the house is clear, you may speak.
I already looked through the rest of the house.
So it's clear.
And then suddenly I'm going to remember finding all the clothes and realize I'm still dressed like this and start taking them off.
Yes, very clear.
Laundry, go and check that other set of footprints that we saw. Make sure it doesn't lead anywhere.
The big ones.
I'm going to go and make sure there aren't any valuables.
Those large, bloody footprints.
No, the other small ones, you dolt.
Because somebody big went through this house.
You were the one in this house! Laundry, I'm going to go and ransack the house. You are going to fuck off.
I'm going to go try and see what footprints he was talking about.
As you go to investigate these footprints and Brad starts to search the house, we'll call it there for the night.
Okay.
You defeated the nest of quarterlings. Good job.
I fucking love Brad and Laundry's dynamic so much.
I was not expecting to go down in that basement and find little people.
I was hoping that one of you spoke halfling.
Oh. I speak the opposite of halfling.
True.
Alright, well, goodbye, everybody.
Bye, Internet.
Later, Brian.